Good morning. How are we on this beautiful weekend in South Wales? Well, I'm in South Wales, but you're not. Yeah, no. Oh no, we're back. Oh, the ZWIFT is struggling. Good morning, Chris. Yeah, I might be doing a lot of standing at 55 RPM when we get to the climbs because I'm on 100% training difficulty. I was saying to Ben earlier, Robin, that it is the season for traditions. I got a bit of a fun fact, but I've never raced on this course before. I've ridden it twice as part of just a free ride, but I've never raced, and I will no doubt find out why. I imagine with a blob this size, it'll be a fairly fast event for those who are still at the front. And I don't think I will be one of those, so Well, it was freezing yesterday morning, and we went out for a group ride, and didn't expect for 1 minute that it would be that cold. And it was a bit of a surprise, to be honest. I knew it was going to be a bit chilly, but it was very cold. No, Chris, 100% training difficulty. I've only got it on it at the minute because I was doing some of the elite races, so it's one of those things that they like force you to ride on and stuff, so I've just left it on that, really. It's weird, I like 100% training difficulty when the route is undulating or when the route is flat, but the minute it goes up massive climbs, I don't like it. Although the other week, or the week before, I did quite a decent time for myself up to ZWIFT, and that was 100%, and it felt really good actually. So maybe it's okay only on certain climbs for me. Bit of a break away. Everybody's different anyway when it comes to training difficulty. Yeah, very true, Robin. I think 63.7 my weight on Zwift, so it's some way off what my weight was when I was doing PBs up after Zwift. Operation Get Strong in full swing. Although some people don't like that, they've corrected me and said, "You're already strong, you should call it Operation Get Stronger." But I think Get Strong sounds better. Macaroni! Bit of gravel. Yeah, I'm a couple of weeks into the gym now, Ian, but I've only been going once a week because it is a very alien experience, so I'm not tempted yet to do, you know, any more than but I will do, and I'm looking forward to that. I'm actually feeling benefits already, but I don't know if it's just in my head. Charlie seems to think it's not in my head and it's complete newbie gains. And because I've never done it properly before, the potential for massive gains could be quite high. But I don't know. We shall see. I definitely feel strong over the short term. Like a couple of sprints or, you know, little climbs, but yeah, no, I don't know, Chris, I don't know. One of my working at the gym, well, currently nothing structured, I'm just attending a class, so it's nothing completely structured yet. Whew. Stringing out. Sorry about the click, by the way. Yeah, Chris, well, the thing is, Chris, it's very similar to any other form of exercise, isn't it? I mean, if you were to only ride your bike once a week, you know, versus twice a week, you'd also notice a difference. So I'm just being a bit careful with it, because the only reason I'm doing it is for a long-term vision, and in terms of performance, I'm only looking to gain from the gym like late into next year, so this time of year, especially as I'm obviously now ramping up training hours on the bike, I'm just being mindful that I don't do too much of everything too quickly. I was just speaking to someone on the group ride yesterday who has just joined the gym, and he's doing a bit of running now, and he's also doing some swimming, and he's like starting to ride more, and I was like, you know, yeah, I appreciate you're excited, and he admitted that he's excited, but it's always important to start small if you can. But it doesn't matter what level of fitness you are, because I know last year I was getting a lot of flack for just going out the door and doing like 10 minute runs. But like, it doesn't matter how fit you are, you know, cycling or whatever your previous sport is, you know, you can't just dive in head first, because it can be, it's not always the case, but it could be a recipe for disaster. Ah, Chris is here, and so is Ben. Oh, so we've got 2, 3 Wahoo local riders in here, I think. I gotta be honest, I was gonna join the back pedal ride race at 9, but when I saw the field level for this, and I saw the route as well, there's Ben Russell, excellent climber. I was going to do that, but then when I saw this, I was like, well, it's not very often to get a chance to ride against people like this, I suppose. No, he's not actually, he's not a triathlete, no. He's just doing something in the winter just to, you know, general fitness. I'll definitely, you know, as I'm doing my gym sessions, I'll definitely pull some more Strava. Obviously, I'll try and keep you in the loop on YouTube as well, because that's always interesting to see, certainly a newbie's progression. But because we often see, yeah, I'll definitely post on Strava. It's because everyone's here, Mick. I better have a drink now, actually. Yeah, I've heard of him, knees over toes guy. Okay, brace yourself, Ed, brace yourself. This could be a bit spicy. Wish me luck. Yeah, and part of why I suppose Phil's recovery has been so good is that gym work as well that he's had in the past. Yeah, low 80s is normally my cadence, yeah. Speaking of Phil, right on. Wow. That was hard. Or at least perceived effort hard. Ugh. Especially as I'm new to it, so there won't be anything I do in the gym. Like I said, the newbie gains will be unlocked. But it's really good. Thank you, Katie. Thank you, Paul. Thank you, guys, to have your insight in it, because the trouble with me is the commitment to it. Because obviously it's not cycling. I'll do it every so often, and then I don't do it. But hearing from you lot, helps with that. Oh no, stringing out again. You're not racing this morning, Paul? Not this, I mean racing in general. Oh, 100k to go. Blimey. Too much riding does that for you, Paul. Can't climb stairs properly. Or go downstairs. I don't know if anybody else finds that. Yeah, when you're really tired. I'm talking specifically about cycling. Although, I suppose the gym has that effect on me right now as well. But my legs just get smoked. Climbing the stairs is a death sentence. Oh no, he was outside! Ah, oh, blooming heck. Oh, that's probably why then. Yeah, going downstairs is probably actually worse than going up, to be fair. Who's that? That's Chris off the front. Or is he sat nice? I think it's in my best interest to try and not do anything in this event and see how far I can get in by holding on. Something I obviously lack at the minute is the whole sort of the technical aspect of riding here, so it's actually probably better for me to get used to riding in a bigger blob and practicing everything that goes into that. Because at the minute, I'm letting myself down in that department. So, and plus it'll help me get a little bit further into this event. Because the Zwift's number one ranked rider apparently is in this race. And it's going to make it very spicy, but there's also tons and tons of top ranked riders here, so it's gonna be a hard race no matter where you are, no doubt. Oh, morning Tom, welcome to the jungle. Oh, Chris has gone solo, got a gap. Having cake. No, we're actually gonna have Sunday dinner. Sunday dinner. No cake today. I had cake yesterday. I had a white chocolate blondie and a cafe. Oh, it was freezing yesterday. So we had to stay in the cafe for a lot longer than we wanted to. That's true, Robin, yeah. Well then, I think I can end mode. I'll just be going a bit slower than usual. Unless it's a short effort. And then I seem to be able to do a bit of head mode. Anyone seen that Netflix documentary, FIFA Uncovered? I'm about halfway through it now. Hey, fun fact, it's 14 degrees in my ZWIFTing space. Which one? I don't know, I'm looking forward to finishing the programme anyway. Because it's kind of interesting. I'm not a bigger fan of football as I used to be, but I'm always intrigued by the ins and outs of stuff like that. Look back. I think I'm going to get some PBs today to the jungle. I don't think I've ever been this fast to the jungle. I don't think I've ever been in a blob this big in the jungle. What's the biggest blob you've been in the jungle? Any big group rides, like, pass through? They probably tend to avoid this, don't they? It's not the best place in the world. And I hear a lot of people... I've not ridden the new routes. In Makuri, but I've definitely been reading and hearing from people that they dislike the amount of varied road surface and that they would just rather more tarmac or a bigger climb. Is that something that you guys are voicing? I've seen the roots from like bird's eye view and I see how much squiggly they are, which I suppose is kind of nice. Is Chris now solo? A fair gap there, isn't he? I think that is Chris. And to be honest, I don't vocalise it, but I would like to see Mount Fuji. I mean, that'd be pretty awesome. Especially as I've been lucky enough to race up it in real life. Because I want to do this winter, I was just writing down a couple of things I want to do on ZWIFT and definitely want to implement that. Yeah, the ZWIFT stuff where we go up at an hour's pace, or we go up a 55 minute pace, or we go up a 50 minute pace. I want to do that this winter and incorporate that into something somehow. And I also want to do a PB up Ventop. And if I can, maybe in spring do a PB up Alp de ZWIFT. But I think Ventop will be a bigger focus this winter. Just because of, I think it's a little bit faster. Well, you can obviously draft for a little bit of it. Whereas Alp de ZWIFT is a bit brutal. Morning, Bert. Riding today? A 20k elevation ride for 20k subs. That'll be 20 hours of riding. Oof. No, I haven't, well, actually, yeah, done an indoor Everest, because we did 10,000 meters of climbing for 10,000 subscribers. What a day that was. I'd like to do an indoor Everest. I might actually, I don't know, in some way I might actually enjoy it, especially if we did it on the radio tower. Although I get 2 hours in and then I definitely wouldn't enjoy it. Everest world record attempt live stream. Oof. Yeah, 20 laps, yeah. Easy. That's an interesting bit. Anyone do any cyclocross here? Do you tend to ride wider bars, or do not seem to matter? Because obviously I'm going to be doing some cyclocross, but hey! A couple of weeks time, I'm even doing the Welsh cyclocross championships. I say doing, I'm probably going to be making up the numbers. Oh, this next half hour is going to be hard, because this is just draggy, and we go straight up. Yeah, epic. Yes, reverse to begin with, but this is likely harder because it could be split here and then you'd be out the back before you even start. Quick question for you guys, would you be interested in seeing like a newbie cycle, like, bearing in mind I'm new to cyclocross, like a mini cyclocross series where I sort of almost like a bit of a I suppose showing you like my skill sessions and my showing how how like maybe between now and December, the last one. Maybe there's a timeline for improvement, like how much, how we capable of improving. Doing my first cyclocross event, and then in 3-4 weeks later, the final one, and seeing if I can improve my finishing position. Obviously, courses will be different, but I'm just trying to think of something, or how I can best document that. Bit of a weird process for me. There's going to be lots of crashes. No bit, no cross, no mountain biking, nothing. Thank you, Phil. Arrow will be doing the cross too, Phil. He's always been a big fan. Get some tips from him. On the bike this morning, Phil, are you out and about, inside, outside? What are you up to? Well, there's a few gravel hill climbs popping up. I know they're not cyclocross hill climbs, but I mean, you don't have to pay for road closure. Trouble is less. Well, I suppose more and more people are getting gravel bikes now, but it does sort of reduce the number of entries you're probably going to get. Well, I won't be able to talk in a minute if it's any consolation. Ah, nice turn, Phil. Must be nice, steady, nice and steady endurance if you're able to multitask. Myself and my mechanic, Emma, we're going for a gravel ride on Wednesday up where Gritfest. I don't know if any of you have heard of that. We're going to do some of the fire roads around there on that event. But some of those climbs, you know, they're quite long. Obviously, if you're riding about, I don't know, about 3 watts per kilo, they probably take you like 20 minutes. They're quite tough climbs. It's quite long. It's generally just because you're going slower rather than, you know, the gradient being super steep. Okay, what's gonna happen on the epic reverse? At what point am I gonna go at the back? At what point it's gonna get strung out? Straight away, probably. I'm avoiding the macaroni. What's quite handy, I've got this motorised sit-to-stand desk, is that if I want to put the TV down lower, so say if I'm, I don't know, going all out in the final minute, and I don't want to look up, but I do want to look down and see the TV, it's quite handy for that, but then I don't get any fan. So by having it up, I get more fan. So it's kind of better for climate because it opens me up. I'm sitting up and watching. Yes, good point. I've got energy. Well said, Rob. Actually, I haven't drunk near enough. Definitely have to eat something at the top of the epic. We don't do radio tower, do we? At least I hope not. Just straight through. Yeah. No, you're right, Jesse, it is tough. You know, I have to remember as well that Phil is a seasoned rider and very much sort of used to the load and, well, used to all aspects of it really, just the mental side of it, physical side of it. Even for me, you know, like I've been doing the hill climbs, I've been doing lower volume. Just getting back into this now, you know, I can't expect to just pick it up straight away. It takes a while to get back into that routine. Yeah, that's right, Nick. Yeah, Mick was saying earlier, he was saying, oh, yuck, you're doing the jungle and you're doing it twice. And Rob was saying, Robin was saying, that's the worst bit. Oh no, here we go then. Bon chance. I might need this feather. And I might need my small ring. Oh no, I'm okay in the big ring so far. There's Ben on Ben's wheel. This is where it gets hard. It goes up and down. A little bit cathartic. My watts do vary. Usually this kicker is about, well, for shorter efforts, it does tend to be a fair bit higher. So what I end up doing is I record both on my head unit now from my power meter, and I delete on Training Peaks the data from the kicker because I wanted to be consistent with obviously my outdoor stuff, otherwise I'll be all of a sudden having like a personal best, for example, by like 5 watts on a 2 minute effort or something, and then I'd know it was from the kicker, so it doesn't, just trying to keep things accurate. Oh, here we go. 7 watts per kilo. Just try and hang in. Yeah. I need all the encouragement. See if I can save this feather for the last bit, because if there's any fireworks, I'll need it. Thank you, guys. Great riding, Chris. Trying my best, Nick. My heart rate doesn't really tell the story here, but it's a little bit suppressed. The red does online. One more kick left. Thank you. That's good news and bad news, Gareth. The good news is it's not what you thought it was. You're not alone, buddy. I had it years ago. Time to draft. I'll drink, don't forget. Oh wow, this is a small group. Blimmin' heck. Although they probably weren't going flat out, were they? I can't switch off now for this bit because it gets a little bit tricky. It's going to get tricky. There's two from the same team here, and obviously two from the same Wahoo. Does anybody know what time we did up there? Couldn't see the... We're all doing 2 watts a kilo now. Pay attention. Minutes 30. Okay, that's a tricky bit done, I think. Thank you. Thank you for the ride on, Rick. Is that Kenny? Jesse, is that Kenny? Are you gonna super tuck a lot? No? Strange. Huh, no super tucks. Oh, it's mad, isn't it? Look, Chris had like almost a minute gap at the bottom of the Epic, and now it's virtually no gap at all. It's not like he's been coasting either. He's been out there a long time, like he's probably been off the front for about 40 minutes. Okay, guess the max speed on you. Oh, am I gonna gamble? Not gonna pedal. Oh, I'm still in there. What rock have you been living under, Tom? Joking. I don't think I can keep Chris company. Like, oh crap. A big gear to push. The flywheel completely stopped. Right, still there. Here comes Chris. We're in a very good position. Yeah, now there's three Wahoo riders in the top 10. The only downside is Chris has been out there the whole time. Wonder if Chris would have made the selection then, if he was in the group. Must have, surely. I feel like the racing's about to just get harder from now on. Because the group's so small and there's three Wahoo riders. Like, it's gonna be spicy. I better check Discord in case they've been typing in there. Hey Marco! Second gap to the group behind. Use me as your motivation, Marco. Oh no. Thank you. Thank you. think I'm going to get caught down here. Yeah, the thing is, the gap is still fairly big, so, and Ben's in there as well, so the longer Ben can serve the wheels, even if it's just for another 10k, he's got a much better opportunity now that the way the race has panned out, he's got better opportunity than me now to finish strong. Yeah, this is quite slow down here. Only downside of ZWIFT is if you're off the front on your own, you can't recover on descent like you would in real life. Seconds, Agnes, but they're coming back really quick, so yeah, true. Yeah, so somebody asked, why is a climber doing this? Well, the race is full of climbers, really, and don't forget, at the end of the day, it's also a good workout, so. They're close enough now that they'll just shut me down on the flat, so unfortunately that's what kills the excitement sometimes. They're close now, but I haven't had any recovery, that's the only problem. Yeah, although we can pretty much write off my race finish now, like the amount of matches I've burnt through there, in the current shape that I'm in, you can pretty much write off my at the end of the day though, the way the race has now panned out, we've got Ben in this front group who has a good chance of finishing really well, so that's what it's turned out to be now. A good chance for Ben with a fairly big group, a fairly big gap to the group behind, so. Not that it was, like, it's funny how some races, they just plan out that way. You don't always, you know, plan for them to happen that way, but yeah, true, they burn matches too, yeah, but yeah, I've had a hard for an hour and a half. Plus, I was also called an idiot. And hopefully now, so if some attacks happen, I can hopefully pull them back for Ben, or I can try and help in some way. No, it wasn't Kevin. I tell you what, I feel like the dynamics have changed. Like, I'm able to stay in the wheel. Like, he's doing 6 watts a kilo. And even when I come right up the back and then coast, it's almost like I stick to the wheel. That's interesting, Nils. Thank you. Roger that, thank you. Even if I get dropped out of this group, there's Chris behind who I can help out potentially. So, Oh, my heart rate is staying up now. That's the first bit of real respite I've had for a long time. That group behind is only 30 seconds. If I can be in a help of some way like that, then it also slightly stalls this group, doesn't it, a little bit, because that group behind is coming back quite quickly. There's a big gap to the next. I use the latest Wahoo ticker. Go on, Ben, go on, go on, go on. Stringing it. Oh. Oh boy. It's about to get very spicy indeed. Good luck then, sir. Good luck, everybody. I have no idea, I've never actually used my legs are starting to seize up now. No surprise, really. I've never used a Neo, I'm afraid, so I can't speak. I am in a world now of suffering. No, I'm still in the big ring. Yeah, and the feather will be of no use here because it's too shallow. I need it where I need it. My legs are really sore at the bottom there, but they're gradually feeling better. Just need to get into a rhythm. Ben's flown the nest now, so go on, Ben. Ooh, yeah, I put myself in a hole, that's for sure. Whew. Go on, Ben. Ben Russell, for the win. I just checked in on Discord and I can see Chris has said he's done. Recovery ride, wink, wink. Did a short turn for Ben before he dropped out. So, I am feeling the same, Chris. Not ready for big efforts like that, but it's good fun. Oh. Oh. My legs are pumped, really pumped. My carbs an hour there probably wasn't high enough, but I think it was probably, what's that, 40, it was probably about 80 there, but I was in a deep hole just from fatigue in general. Like, all the nutrition in the world would obviously only go so far as to help you when you're going deep, deep, deep. And then it all comes down to your current fitness level. And I think I deliberately set my stall out there to put myself in a bit of a troublesome position. And when you have numbers in a race, like Chris and we had Ben, sometimes it's the way the race works out, it can be more beneficial to work for a teammate. As many of you know who are part of teams, it's sometimes just as fun, if not more fun, seeing someone else get further into the race and to have played a part in it. I mean, hopefully I played a part in it. Maybe I was just a pain in the bum. But I think I'll just spin up here now for a little bit and then I'll exit the event and descend back down. We'll keep the chat going while I'm still here. Whew. It's good. It's good when you're racing against, well, for example, the highest ranked rider on Zwift is in this race in our front group. It's good when you're racing against elite riders. Doesn't matter what level you are or where you are in terms of fitness. But the race is in bits, so considering how big the group was. Look at this. A minute and a half back to the next group. And they're not hanging about, look, they're doing nearly 5 watts per kilo. It was Rocky Mountain, Josh. Oh. Yeah, that's it. Hour and 50. Oh. Well, hopefully, like, as we gradually get a little bit fitter and fitter, we'll get further and further into the race and play a bit of a bigger part in it, and maybe even get back to where we were getting some results. So yeah, I've got a V60, Josh, but I prefer the AeroPress. I tend to use the AeroPress more often. Charlie uses a V60 more because she's afraid of, like, spilling the everything that's inside the AeroPress. Thank you, Agnes. I wish I could stream in summer. Just gets so warm in here, you know. Oh, I went for a group ride yesterday, yeah. It was a good little spin. Yeah, that was a good day, that one. That was a good day in racing. I don't actually remember much of it, but I remember it being a good leg day, that's for sure. Oh. It's mad, like, it's mad how comfortable, like, earlier in the race, like, doing the long efforts, just settling in, and, you know, we all have our different strengths and weaknesses, but for me, just settling in and just trying to ride at that, like, you know, it's uncomfortable, but it's just barely sustainable. It's not flat out, it's just below there, and it just feels, for me, it just feels very nice and very natural. And for some people, it's the opposite, they feel absolutely horrific. But doing those efforts, they're like bread and butter, they always have been. It's just you see them now because obviously there's technology and live streams and stuff. comes another group. Oh, fairly big group this one. Fairly big group. And they're almost in the top 10, that group. Oh, how was your run? What happened? Got dropped. That's about my limit currently. I mean, I went over my limit by going on the attack, I suppose, but it's all good fun, isn't it? You know how much I love a good effort off the front. The ticker, this is quite old, this one. I've had it a good few years. It works pretty well for me, I've got to be honest. Yeah, use it every time I ride indoors. It does have some problems sometimes, you know, when you're maybe at the start of a race and you go at the pen, sometimes it stays at like 90 beats a minute for like 30-40 seconds and then it quickly catches up, but yeah, it's pretty good. No worries, Jeremy. I'll be bang on 2 hours. I'll be good timing. Love to have a TSS guess for this one. Have a guess. How much TSS I have? Ah. Oh. Actually, I could live stream the race up front, come on. Oh. Put the effort in. There's no way I'm catching up now. Oh. Lovely jubbly. Oh. Ooh. How is he getting on? Okay, so he's gone solo then. What the heck? Fair way to go. Fair way to go. So this guy here, guys, is the number one ranked right on ZWIFT. So I've been told. Still holding close to 6 watts per kilo. Well, 5.5 to 6, which is pretty decent considering the 2 hours in. Who am I kidding? That's outrageous. Not pretty decent, really. Says Ben. Ben's holding on to a 15 second gap to third place. And two guys. KH not on ZWIFT power, but at the minute Ben's looking good for a podium if he keeps on keeping on. That's Caden's Ben. That's weird, isn't it? The cadence of the avatar looks higher than 80 or 77. Or is it me? 18:46 of that climb. So Ben's gonna do a run about 19 minute epic time. And quick descent now, so go on Ben, nearly there, nearly there. Gaps growing to the groups behind or the riders behind. Alright, we're ramping up there, guys. It's been a productive morning on two wheels. Thank you so much for joining. Here I am. Let's have a look at the end product. Oh, it's nasty. Although some good training, but also stretching myself out a little bit there. So, you know, from here to here, be interesting to see what that averages out at. It's not a million miles away from, not a million miles at all, but 20, 25 watts, huh? That's okay. So 150 TSS. You're not gonna get fitter if you stop and it gets tough. No, you get fitter when you recover. Very true. That wraps up a 20-hour week this week, so that is pretty decent. I'm gonna take a recovery day tomorrow and then add building the blocks again next week. Up to 23 hours potentially, and probably keep a little bit of this with racing in for the intensity for a bit of fun, because it is very fun when I live stream. It's very fun to race, very fun to race with people. So yeah, nice one. Right, everyone, thanks for watching. Thank you, Rob. Close key to 125. 149 was the end product, so thanks for watching, everybody. I'll see you in the next one.